Hi everyone, welcome back to the DBMS lab session. In today's lab, we are going to work with conversion functions. Let me give you a brief introduction of what is conversion and all that. Sometimes there may be a scenario where the query expects input in a specific data type, but it receives it in a different data type. So in such cases, what Oracle does is it implicitly tries to convert the unexpected result that it has got to a compatible data type, which can be substituted in place of where it is needed so that the application continuity is not compromised. So this type of conversion, wherein Oracle itself will try to convert the unexpected type into the specific type, then this is called as implicit conversion. And sometimes maybe the programmer himself wants to convert a data type specifically to another data type. This is called as explicit type data type conversion. And SQL supports three kinds of type conversions. So the first one is type conversion functions. They are to char, to number, and to date. Okay, so these are the three types of functions which perform cross modifications on the data types. So let us look into what is to char. So to char is used to typecast a numerical value or a date input to a character type. So you'll be giving a integer or you'll be giving a date. So it will be converting it into a character type. So here I have done the same thing. So here I have applied the to char. Now you might be wondering, what is this dual? Dual is an default dummy table that will be available with the Oracle. So this table, we are using this table because the select syntax do not support if you are not giving from. I explained you this in the conceptual evaluation strategy, that whatever may be, you need to have select and from. The table need to mentioned. So we are not applying it on any table. We are just looking, we are just converting the number. We are just practicing it. So that's why I have kept the table to be dual. Okay, so I said select to char and I'm passing in the numerical value. So the numerical value is 6789 and this will be converted into the character type now. So I'll show you the execution of this program. So you can see it is converted into character. So 6789 is a char type now, and you can use this in your comparison. Okay, so when you are working with your comparison operators and all that, it is needed that the both variables types are same. Okay, so then only you can apply this comparison operators and all that. So in such cases, like, you will be needing to convert. Okay, so this is how you convert the numerical type into the character type. Now I'm converting the system date. So SYS date is the system date. So I'm converting the system date to character. So I said select to underscore char system date from dual. So you can see it is showing me the date, but this date is the char type now. Okay, so it was the date type. System date is of date type. Now it has become the char type and it is showing 24th June 21. Okay, and the next one is, like, we are taking two arguments here. So the first one is system date and you want it to be in terms of month, date and year. So let us see whether it will print it in that format or not. So I'm saying month. So the month has come before. So in the previous case, if you remember the output, it has shown me 24th June 2021. Now the month has come before. So you can even format how you want the date to be shown. In the next case, like, I am having the date and I am giving, rather than taking the system date, I am giving the date as an input and I am converting this to the date format, because this is a string over here now. So I'm converting these two things into the date and then I'm converting it to the char type. So I can have two conversions over here. So let me show you. Okay, so it is 24 June 21. Okay, right. So because it is 24 6, right? So this is 6 is June. So it is converting into June. And you can also give it in this format, like separated, the months and years are separated by slash. So here first the string is converted to date and then it is converted to the string. So it is 9th July 2003. Okay, right. And this is another format which is valid format. So here I didn't give any slashes and all that. So you can see it is showing me the date, that 9th July 2003. So you can see here 9th July 2003, so this is the middle, right? The month is in the middle, so whatever is in the middle it is taking it to be month. So this is where I am directly converting into the date format. So the string is converted into the date format. So you can see like it is 15 March 2002. Okay, so this is how conversions happen. Like you are giving to the date, to underscore date, you are giving the string and you are converting it into the date format. I think you remember, like I have given the same conversion in the reserves table. While inserting tuples into the reserves table, I have given the date, month and year, and I have converted into the date format. So this is how I am converting the string into date. The next one is to number. So to number is used to convert a character into the number. So I have taken a character, so this is the char 765.45, since I have put it in the single quotes. See, okay, so this is char and this is how I convert. The function name is to number, and so it will take in a char and convert it into a number. So you can see 765.45, so which is a number. So this is how you put it in the query. Okay, fine. And the next are string functions. The first one is concatenation function. So I said select concat. The name of the function is concat. Then I am saying Sudha and DBMS. I have given two words over here and I want it to concatenate it. So let me show you the result. So you can see concat Sudha and DBMS. It is showing me Sudha DBMS. It has concatenated both the strings. And next is concat, wherein I have applied it on the boats table. Okay, so what I did, I said I want BID and BName. BID and BName are the attributes of the boats table. I want it to concatenate BID and BName. I'll show you what is the result. So here I'm concatenating BID and BName. So you can see the BID and BName both are concatenated. And even you can see the values in the column, like 101 interlake, so both are concatenated, you know, 102 and interlake, and 103 clipper and 104 marine. So these both columns have been concatenated. So I just wanted to show you on the tables. Okay, so this is how you can apply the concat on the table. And then this is left pad. So I said select left Sudha, and then I said 10 and then a star. So what does this mean? So I am saying it to consider 10 columns, and in the 10 columns I am asking it to put this string on the extreme right and pad stars on the left side. So that is left padding. Okay, so I want this Sudha to be on the, in the 10 columns, in the 10 columns I want Sudha to be right aligned, in the sense it should be in the right, and the remaining characters on the left should be padded with the star. Okay, so that is left padding. So the opposite of this is the right padding. So I want Sudha to be aligned onto the left side and put the star on the right side. Okay, fine. So you can see that. So you can replace the star to any of the characters. So it is padding the right side spaces with an asterisk. Now you can see how many I am mentioning here. I am saying 10, consider only 10 columns. So Sudha is occupying 5 columns, and the rest of the 5 columns I wanted to put star. Okay, so in place of star you can replace it with anything. And the next one is a trim operation. So it is left trim. So what I am saying, I said I want SID to be there in the result. And coming to, I want SName also to be in the result, but I want the name, okay, SName to be trimmed with the left trim with h, means that the first letter, if the s name is having s name will be having the names of the sailors, right? And if there is h, I want the h to be trimmed, meaning that I want it to remove h. So you can see that I want SID, so SID appeared in the result. And so I want the s name to have this trim option. So wherein I said remove h, so you can see there are two Horatios, right? That's why I have given h over here. So the first left trim, the first character is h, so it is removed. But for Dustin, Brutus, Lubber and all that, there is no h in the first place, so that's why it is not removed. Only for Horatio, both the Horatios, h is gone or h is trimmed off. Okay, so this is left trim. In the similar way, right trim also works. So I said remove y. Okay, if there is y in the right of the s name, I am asking to take it off or trim it off. I have given y because we are having two people here, y with y, Andy and Rusty. So you can see this is right trim, right? So on the right side we are checking whether y is there. So Dustin is having n, so we cannot trim it because n is not equal to y. So s you cannot trim, r you cannot trim. So Andy, y is there, so y is trimmed off, so y is not there. For Rusty, y is there, y is trimmed off, and likewise for the other sailors also. So this is right trim. So the next is I want to convert it to lower. So I am saying B name. I want the boat names to be converted, all the boat name values to be converted to lower. So I said lower. So this is a function, so string function. So I want BIDs also to appear on the in the result. So I said BID comma lower B name. So you can see all the values in the B name column has been converted to lower. So interlake, every character in this particular string has been converted to lower. So this is lower. Now in the similar way, the upper is vice versa of lower. So you can see it. So in the S name, okay, I applied this on the sailors table, right? So S name, all the S names have been now converted to uppercase. So we are saying uppercase, so everything is converted to uppercase. So upper is a function here, and whatever attribute you want to convert, you will be passing this as an argument into this upper function. Okay, and the next one is init cap. So init cap is like converting it into camel case. Camel case means the first letters become capital. So the first letter in S name will become capital. So let me show you the result of this query. So you can see the first letters have become capital. So Dustin, D is capital, B is capital, L is capital and all that. So if you want to make them capital, you can use this init capital. Init means the initial letter being capital. Okay, fine. I'll show you with this. You will be understanding it. So I am passing some string over here, which is Sudha Sinu. So let me show you how it is capitalized. So you can see that this S is capitalized and this S is capitalized. Okay, so I have passed all small cases, but you can see this first S and this S have been capitalized. So the next function is length function. So the length function will count the number of characters in the string passed. So here I have passed a string which is welcome to DBMS by Sudha. So it will count all the characters here including the spaces and it will give me the result. Make a look at the result. So it is 24. Okay, so the number of characters are 24 even including the spaces. Now the next one is I am trying to find out the length of SID and length of S name. So let me show you the result of this. So I said select SID, length SID, S name, length S name, and from sailors table. Okay, fine. So I'll be getting two columns over here extra. So the SID, the count 2 are 2, right? 292 numbers are there. So all are 2 numbers. And Dustin is 6 characters long. So the length of Dustin is 6, Brutus 6 and so on. Andy is 4 and all that. Bob is 3. Okay, so this is how I can use the length function. And the next one is substring. Okay, so select BID substring B name 3, 4. And I also want the boat color. So I want BID and then I want from B name I just want the from the third character I want four characters. From the third character I want four characters to be printed. So that is this 3 and 3. Okay, so 3 means from where to start, 3 means the position from where to start, 4 means how many characters you want in the result. So that is 4. Okay, so so this is the size of the substring. You can say 4 is the size of the substring. So let me run this and show you the result. So you can see that so from the third character it is beginning. So you can see interlake, right? Interlake. So T is the third character, and from the third character I want four characters to be printed. So four characters are there. So since I said four, you can see in every value there are four characters starting from the third position. Okay, so this is substring. And here the string number, the first character in the string starts with 1 only. It is not with 0. Okay, because we in programming languages generally start the string with the 0. But here the string starts with 1 only. Okay, right. And next is in string. So this in string will actually count the characters. Okay, so let me show you the output. So it is 11, right? So it is giving me the count. So in string will give me the count. What count it will be giving? It will actually search for this AB in this string. In this entire string we want to search whether whether AB is there. But from where you want to start the search? You want to start the search after two characters. Okay, so you want to search this string after the two characters. So it will start searching from C. And this 3 is that you want the position of the third occurrence of AB. So from C it is starting, right? So the first occurrence of AB is here. So this is the first occurrence of AB. And this is the second occurrence of AB. And this is the third occurrence of AB. Okay, so you can see here. Okay, so this is the third occurrence of AB and I want the position. So now count it from C. It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And I want the after the next position after you found the string. So this is AB, right? So this is the last occurrence, means third occurrence. You want the third occurrence. You have passed 3 as a parameter. So immediate next position after the occurrence of the string. So that is 11. So that's why you have got 11. So I hope it is understood. Okay. So in string is that. And next one is translate. Okay. So translate will convert. So here I want A to be replaced with B. So I'm saying I'm giving. So this is the string. I want wherever there is A, replace it with B. So that's what I told. Is this translate. So you can see that wherever there is A, okay, so B is replaced. Fine. So this is translate. And the next query is where I'm using translate on the Sailor's table, where I want to replace the occurrences of lowercase a with the capital I for the S name. S name is an attribute in the Sailor's table. So I want to replace lowercase a with the capital I. So you can see here that Horatio, right? So A is there. So in place of lowercase a, I has been replaced. And Zorba for A, I has been replaced. And Horatio, A has been replaced. And you can see that for the capital letters, it didn't replace. Because in the query, I said for lowercase a, replace with capital I. Okay, fine. So this is regarding the translate function. And the next one is the replace function. So here I'm giving the string. So I'm asking it to replace LA with Sudha. Okay. So for the boat's name. So you have that interlake and all that. So I want it to replace. So here you can see interlake LA is there, right? So LA is replaced with Sudha. So you can see LA is replaced and KE is there at the end. Lake. In the lake, I have taken off LA and I have put Sudha over here. For both the interlakes, it is replacing with Sudha. This is replacing a string. And the next is date functions. So the date functions, as I already told you, select system date from dual. So wherein you can see the system date. So what is the system date? System date is 24th June 21, and you can convert the string into to date, which I already have told you. So you can see that it is 15th May 2015. Okay, so it is showing me the date. And then this is converting the system date to 2 char. Okay, so this is conversion. So this is the system date and this is the time. So it is showing the time over here, and which is converted to char. And we also have another function which is next underscore day. So which will give the next day over here. So the next day is 22nd Feb, right? So it will give the next day. So you can see 22nd Feb 2018. So next day will give the next day. So you can use them in your queries, like in case if the train is delayed, so you can change it to the next day and all that. So next is select SID day, add months. So here you can add 20. So here you are saying add months to the day. You are saying add months to the day, and you are saying add 20 months. Okay. So here you are saying add months to the day. And you are saying you are passing the day, and from the day you want to add 20 months. So we are applying this on the reserves table. So you can compare. So I am having SID day and also the added 20 months date. So you can see here. Okay, so 20 months are added. So it has gone to 2000 year here. So this is the original day and date, and then this is after adding 20 months to this date. Okay, fine. So you can also change this. So I have changed the dates of the reserves table. And then the next one is like last day. Okay, so I applied this on the sailors table. So I'm saying s dot s name day, and the last day, day from the sailors reserves, where s dot sid is equal to r dot sid. Okay, fine. So let us look at the result. So you can see the result. Okay, so this is the day actually, and the last day is the last day in the month. So 31st is there in October, so it is showing 31st. And for August also you have 31st, for July also you have 31st, and for October also you have 31st, for June you have only 30 is the last date of June month, so it is showing 30, for December 31, and for May 31, and so on. So last day will print the last date in that particular month. And the next one is months between. So this will calculate the difference between the system date and the day that you have given. So the system date is 24 June, right? So it is showing me the months between the this date and the system date. What is system date? I already have shown you the system date, which is 24th June 21. So it is 272 months. Okay, fine. And the next one is the functions which are least and greatest and truncate and round. Let us see. The least function will give the least among the numbers passed as arguments. So I have passed 177, 1 and 32. So I'll be getting 1 as the least among this. And so among the strings, like it will be giving, comparing in terms of lexical order. So the least is bananas. Okay. And next, coming to the greatest. So it is the vice versa of least. So where it is giving the greatest, which is 100 among these numbers. And the greatest among all these will be oranges. Okay. So because it appears lexically, it is greatest compared to apples and bananas. And the next one is truncate. Now coming to the truncate. So truncate, I'm giving these. I'm giving a number and I'm saying truncate. So what it will do? Okay, so it will remove all the decimal numbers. So after the decimal point, the numbers over here, the fractional part, it will be removing. So I'll just have 9256. Okay, if I want to keep the fractional part, I have to mention how many digits in the fraction I want. So for example, I can pass it 2 here. It means that comma 0. Okay, so that's why we don't want any fractional part. It means that we don't want any fractional part. So here I'm saying it is 2, so it will just keep 1 and 1. The rest of the after decimal, how many digits I want. So I want 2 digits after decimal. So it will keep 1 and 1. The rest of the numbers will be truncated. Now we'll see what is round. Okay, so the round means that, so you can see I have given 9256. It is taking off all these fractional parts. Don't worry, I'll show you the difference between truncate and round. So it has removed all these things and it has given me 9256. Okay, so you might be thinking round and truncate are doing the same thing. No, they have got different purpose. Now I'm saying round off to, I want one digit after the decimal. So it is keeping one digit after the decimal point. Now I'll show you the difference between the truncate and round, wherein I have given both in the select query. So same number I have given, and let us watch what will be the output, and I'll explain you that. It is self-explanatory, you will be able to understand. So here see what truncate did. I passed 95.61, it just kept 95 and it just removed. Truncation is just deleting the numbers, okay? So you don't want the decimal, it will just remove it. That's it, it is just removing the numbers. Rounding, that taking the number to the next highest number. So 96 95.6, right? So when I say round, it will take it to the nearest highest number. So the nearest number, nearest highest number is 96. So it is taking it to the nearest highest number because it is 0.6. So I hope the difference between truncate and round is clear to my class. Okay, so these are all the functions that are there in your fifth experiment. So we have seen the conversion functions, two char, two number and two date. And we also have seen the string functions, concat, left pad, right pad, left trim, right trim, lower, upper, init, cap, length, substring and instring. And the date functions, we have seen what is system date, next date, add months, last day, months between. So all these are the date functions we have seen. And we also have seen least, greatest, truncate and round. So I hope this video is helpful to you. Thank you.